are the worst of times. I do believe it's true. When people lock their doors and hide inside, rumor has it it's the end of paradise. But I know if the world just passed us by, baby, I know. The worst of times. I do believe it's true. I feel so helpless, like a boat against the tide. I wish the summer wind could bring back paradise, but I know.
Father and Lord, we thank you as we gather tonight to celebrate this milestone in our lives. We are grateful for the guidance and love we have received from our parents, friends, families, and teachers. As we take another step in our individual paths of growth and maturity, may you always be the guide we seek to solve life's questions. Help us to look for joy and hope in the life you have given us, and strive to share it with others. May we use our lives to make this world a better place in which to live. Amen.
Thank you.
best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. It was the epoch of belief. It was the epoch of incredulity. It was the season of light. It was the season of darkness. It was the spring of hope. It was the winter of despair. We had everything before us, and we had nothing before us. 214 years ago, Charles Dickens opened his novel, A Tale of Two Cities, with these words, and surprisingly, they still apply today to our high school years. Being here this evening at our graduation is an achievement we can all be proud of, because it signifies the trying times we've all survived and grown from. In our years of rush, we've all known hard times, and through them all, we've had each other to lean on. Our first task was finding our place among pupils and friends. Since then, we've come across many conflicts, conflicts which had no right or wrong, but the resolution was of greatest importance. We learned there were many decisions with which responsibility came. With responsibility came pressure. Dealing with the pressure and changes in our lives took the greatest amount of stamina and durability. And how can pressure be mentioned without mentioning work? Whether it was studying for tests, practicing speaking coordination in sport, memorizing script lines, or reading pages and pages to complete assignments, the work was there and the time limits were set. It was a great balancing act of managing schoolwork, extracurricular activities, a job, and a social life all at the same time. Because of all the pressures and demands of life, we all had to realize our limitations. Accepting our limitations once we identified them was one of the hardest parts of growing up, and still is. The next step was to face our limitations and expand on our possibilities. It was a time of foolishness. In making many decisions, it was inevitable that we would display some foolishness. This was especially easy as freshmen, finding our way through the maze of halls, sometimes even showing up in the wrong class, or worse yet, staying up all night to finish an assignment and then forgetting to bring it to school. However, high school was a learning process not only through our studies, but through learning from our mistakes. It was a time of incredulity, disbelief in authority, and even disbelief in ourselves. Relationships we thought would last forever sometimes broke up, causing heartache and leaving us questioning why. It was picking ourselves up from failure and having the faith we could make it. It was a time of despair. We've all gone through difficult times when it seemed like nothing would ever get better. Mostly, sadness comes from changes. This part of our lives is over now. Society. And perhaps the saddest part is leaving our friends in whom we have found comfort, trust, and happiness. All our past despair, pressure, and worries fade as we now face the uncertainty of the future. We can face tomorrow with the confidence that we've grown from our experiences.
Fading as the best of times begin to find their way into our final high school passage. These times are measured from significant experiences and memories through the past 4 years. Through the years of our development, trust, faith, and love. Trust that life is ultimately good. Faith that friends will be there to support us. And love, from teenage infatuations to deep and abiding friendships, become everlasting memories. These moments are bright, vivid memories. All the faculty and students, especially all you seniors here, are pieces of our times. At certain instances, these individuals stand out sharply, acknowledging and attesting to the influence each has had on us as a class. Then there are those people not immediately apparent to a casual observer, such as secretaries, hall monitors, custodians, or cafeteria workers. But the beauty of them is that they will be forever an integral part of our impression of Brush. Early in our passage through high school, many of our decisions were made for us by others. But our education bestowed upon us knowledge, stimulated creativity as we developed priorities, and most of all, gained wisdom upon which to face choices. Through these choices, we attain confidence and no longer saw things as impossible, but believed in our potential, especially in ourselves. This was the epic of belief. Now our high school passage reaches its end, leaving behind memories, whether they are pleasant or unpleasant, lasting or fleeting, important or trivial. They will each carry a certain amount of significance into the future. With these memories, there comes a ray of hope. Hope that in the future, we'll be able to have experience that start another period that provide memories of the best part of our lives. Thank you.
Parents, guests, staff, graduates, it was my sincere pleasure and responsibility to present you as a class. I'd like to call forward at this time our superintendent, Dr. Lawrence Larraza. Larraza. Dr. Larraza, I would like to certify that the class of 1989 has met all the requirements established by our own local South Euclid-Lyndhurst Board of Education and also the State Department of Education. I present to you the class of 1989 for graduation. Class, if you please rise.
Of the South Euclid-Lyndhurst City School District, I hereby accept the class of 1989 for graduation. The fine history of excellence that makes up Charles Brush High School has indeed been reflected in the accomplishments of the class of 1989. You, its current graduating class, typify this tradition in many ways. This class has carried forward a tradition of excellence in academics, responsibility as young adults, and prowess on the athletic fields. Merit scholars, championship teams, and contributions to our community represent the quality of integrity these young people have brought to our school district. Congratulations to each and every one of you. On behalf of the family of employees of the South Euclid-Lyndhurst School District, you are indeed a class with class. I would like to turn my attention now to some loving and caring people behind all of this. Parents and grandparents, would you please stand? Can we give them a round of applause? Personally, you've got what it takes. It's my hope now that indeed you will go for it and make us even prouder of your accomplishments in the future. One of the five people who works very diligently and very hard to make all of this happen is the president of our Board of Education, indeed a real leader for all of us. I'd like to call forward now Mr. Paul Sabatino.
Thank you. I guess I shouldn't touch these. If I don't, I can't see my numbers. I would like to begin by congratulating our student speakers, Tony Miner and Joe Favazzo, for their outstanding speeches. Each year, I am more and more impressed with the quality of the speeches being presented. Great job. Also, congratulations to our valedictorian, David Levitin, and to his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Levitin. Also, congratulations to our salutatorian, Joe Favazzo, and his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Favazzo. extremely proud of you for your outstanding academic achievements. This is the fourth opportunity I have had to give a commencement speech. And I have to tell you that this is one of the most pleasant tasks that a board member has an opportunity to perform. Commencement is not only a special day for our graduates and their parents, but it is a great day for our Board of Education and for our staff. Dr. Marazza, Mr. Leonetti, fellow Board of Education members, staff, parents, relatives, friends, and most importantly, honored members of the graduating class of 1989. I am very pleased and very proud to have the opportunity to say a few words to you this evening, not only as the president of the school board, but also, like so many of you, as a proud parent of one of our graduating seniors and a proud parent or proud uncle of another. I'm especially proud because around this same time, 34 years ago, I too had the privilege of graduating from Brush High School. As I look back over the past 34 years, I can honestly say that Brush High School was an excellent school, a school with staff, programs, and a curriculum that prepared me and my classmates well for the future. As a school board member, I have had the opportunity to observe the school and its staff and its programs very closely and very carefully. And again, I can honestly say that Brush High School is still an outstanding school with excellent programs and a very caring and competent teaching and administrative staff. I sincerely hope that as you go on to higher education or into the world of work, you will find that you too will be well prepared academically, socially, and with a value system which will allow each of you to take your place in a very complex society as caring and productive citizens. In doing so, I would encourage each of you to get as much education as you can so that you can get the kind of job you want and enjoy. I recently read a statistic which indicated that on the average, a person after graduating from high school and college works on a job anywhere from 36 to 40 years before retirement. You can all relate to this period of time now because you have just completed 12 years of formal education. I would like to, once again, start kindergarten and go through 12 more years of school, graduate, and start over again for another 12 years. It seems like an infinite period of time. Again, that is why it is so important to have a good education and to enjoy what you are doing in the workplace. Be an opportunist. Take advantage of opportunities that could be beneficial to you. Remember, the concept of education and the learning process is a continuous one. Education alone will not always get you the job you want, and education alone will not always open the door to success. But in many cases, it will open the door and allow you to present yourself. You will never have too much education. But with this statement, and around the same time each year, I am reminded of a story I heard over 30 years ago. The story goes something like this. Two wise men were walking across a very rough terrain and heard a voice from afar. The voice told them to stop and fill their pockets with stones. The voice then said, "If you do this, tomorrow you will be both happy and sad." Without thinking too much about this, the two wise men filled their pockets with stones and went on their way. The next day, the men were again walking and noticed something shiny in their pockets. As they looked, they discovered that the stones had turned to precious gems. The one man said, "I'm really happy that we got some of those stones." The other man said, "Yes, but I'm sad we did not get more." As the many tomorrows come, you will always be happy for the education you have, for it too can turn into something of value. And in some cases, you will be sad that you did not have more education. So to you, I say, don't be afraid to pick up too many stones along the way. Also, in the many tomorrows, you will be making many decisions, important decisions, decisions which can and will affect your future and your lives. I would suggest, as you begin to think about your future goals and aspirations, you involve and consult your parents. It's always great to hear young adults make statements like, I talk with my parents, or I talk with my mom, or I talk with my dad, and we decided, or I decided. Remember, we as parents are interested in your future and do care and want to see each and every one of you find success and happiness in all that you do. Someday you too will be parents, and you will want your children to come to you with their concerns and with their questions. So please give us as parents that opportunity and honor. We are your number one cheerleaders. Remember, we were a part of your past, and we want to share in your future. In fact, I think that a little part of each of your diploma belongs to your parents for the encouragement, for the love, and for the support they have given you over the years, and for the financial support they have given to this school district, which has allowed us to provide you with a quality education. For that support, for that love, and for that encouragement, I would also ask all of our graduates to again join with me in giving your parents a well-deserved round of applause. And for those parents who graduated from Brush High School, I thank you for staying in our communities. Lastly, the South Duke of Lyndhurst Board of Education is very happy and privileged to award you your diploma for your hard work and fine efforts over the past 4 years. You as recipients can be extremely proud to be receiving a diploma from one of Ohio's finest schools, Brush High School. In conclusion, I would like to say to each of our graduates, as you go through life, may you always have enough happiness to keep you pleasant, enough trials to challenge you, enough sorrow to make you compassionate, enough faith to urge you on, enough failure to maintain your humility, enough health to keep you smiling, enough friends to share life with, enough wealth to meet your needs, enough faith to sustain you, and enough work for your hand and mind, and enough love to fill every corner of your heart. Good luck, and God bless each and every one of you. Thank you.
Before we begin the wonderful task of awarding our diplomas, I'd like to ask you to bow your head a moment for a gentleman who began his teaching career over 20 years ago at Brush High School, Jim Smith, business education teacher, coach, friend of many of our young people, passed away this spring at the age of 46. He left a family of three youngsters and his wife. If you would please bow your head for a moment in Jim Smith's memory. Levinson, would you please step forward? Mr. Paul Sabatino, please step forward. Sabatino, I want you to know that David Levinson is our class valedictorian. David completed his high school career, at least seven semesters of his high school career, with a 4.2 plus average and a very vigorous high school curriculum. David's on his way to Miami University at Oxford. He's been not only an outstanding student, but he's been involved in a variety of activities. He's been a member of our tennis team. He's been on our whiz team. He's been a member of our silent sports club. And he's been active in the NHS, the AFS. Sometimes you wonder how such a young man can find the time, but David's been a real asset and a tribute to our high school, and I know that his career at Miami of Ohio is going to be just as successful. David's also won scholarships given by the PTSA, the Ohio Board of Regents, and the Bond U Group Scholarship. At this time, Mr. Sabatino, I'd like to present David Levitin, our number one student. Joseph Favazzo, would you please step forward? Joseph, our salutatorian, has also distinguished himself as a scholar at Brush High School, one of whom we are very proud of. Joe, during his 4 years, achieved a 4.11 plus average in a very vigorous program. Joe is going to be heading toward my alma mater, University of Notre Dame, where he will be pursuing a career in medicine. And like David, Joseph's been a young man who's found time not only to distinguish himself as a scholar, to find time to be active in a variety of things. He's a class president in grades 9 and 10. He's worked with our student congress. He's been a member of NHS. He's been a tri-captain of our soccer team and also been very active in soccer during his entire 4-year period. Joseph, congratulations. Begin awarding our diplomas, but I say this every year, and I say it in all sincerity, our graduation moves very quickly. You will be out of this arena in another 20 minutes, but it's important that we hear the names of each graduate as they are read, and in so many instances, we're so anxious to applaud a specific graduate that we miss the name of another, so please cooperate. We will move the stage and you will have an opportunity to recognize each graduate at the appropriate time. Thank you.
Don Scafidi, Brian Besden, Aaron Adano, Tony Miner, Howard Adelstein, Charles Kohler, Stephen Adelstein, Justin Konesny, Colleen Adenolfi, Douglas Cordell, Michelle Albee, Paul Kostiak, Fabrian Alexander, Karen Kovach, Daryl Ambrose, Marcus Kucharski, Kevin Amos, Jason Kuzma, Kevin Anderson, Michael Currit, Christopher Anderson, Eric Kvarda, Michael Anderson, Darlene LaRich, Scott Anderson, Karen Lally, Ronald Anselmo, Brett Landing, Juliet Armenti, Charity Lansman, Matthew Artali, Lori Linnies, Igor Eisman, Jason Lang, Kimberly Baggett, Kelly Lanham, Suzanne Baker, Teresa Lasher, Jeff Barklow, Dominic Lorenzo, Christopher Bartlett,
Maria Lorienzo.
Paul Barcelato.
William Laws.
Robert Batchelet.
Isabella Leichman.
Jim Batcher.
Mark Lear.
Katrina Bell.
Jonathan Lee.
Theodore Bell.
David Letsky.
Toya Benford.
John Levesque.
Jennifer Benjamin.
Kevin Lewis.
Nicole Bergeron.
Christine Linke.
Gretchen Bergman.
Suzanne Lombardo.
Richard Berkowitz.
Sharon Longano.
Laurie Bernard.
Carl Lopresti.
Kathleen Bichara.
Christine Lowes.
William Birch.
Curtis Logan.
David Biro.
Diane Lowy.
Darcy Biscock.
Barbara McAdam.
Jonathan Bizjack.
Jeffrey Major.
David Bocci.
Michelle Mafrisi.
Christopher Bowen.
Christine Marble.
Scott Brennis.
Matthew Marconi.
Linda Brown.
Mara Marks.
Margaret Brown.
Brian Mart.
Janice Brunello.
Melissa Mason.
Lisa Bubanik.
Christopher Matero.
Carol Buckhans.
Christopher Mayberry.
Jeffrey Bueller.
Mark McDaniel.
Tracy Burns.
Michael McGinnis.
Marla Butler.
Karen McGrath.
Bathsheba Bird.
Patrice McNeely.
Kristen Kala.
Elisa McCauley.
Jennifer Calmer.
David Metzger.
Anthony Carciopolo.
Mary Miller.
Larvette Carlton.
Scott Myelo.
Jennifer Carmichael.
Heather Miner.
James Carroll.
Lori Mintz.
Anthony Cardelloni.
Robert Maiozzi.
Kimberly Carver.
Allison Zuckerman.
Mark Casey.
Michelle Zucker.
Laurie Kasiri.
Kenny Young. Kimberly Meyer. Please recognize this section of graduates. Joseph Mitchin.
Louis Chaitin.
Monique Mixner.
Richard Chesler.
Elizabeth Glennick.
Brian Cianciolo.
Mark Mullough.
Donald Charlillo.
Michael Monetary.
Jeffrey Cohen.
Vicky Morrow.
Michael Kaleva.
Edward Neer.
Lynn Caniglio.
Wendy Newman.
Michael Conley.
Daniel Nice.
Janet Conti.
Darren Nicole.
Monique Cooper.
Scott Neters.
John Cornwell.
Thomas Norton.
Jason Corrigan.
Roger Noodleman.
Terry Kowalski.
Judith O'Brien.
Sherry Crow.
Aaron Olin.
Kevin Crown.
Katie O'Toole.
Jeffrey Curtis.
Linda Peck.
Lara D'Alessandro.
Brian Pallison.
Angela DeMore.
Matthew Pancher.
Michelle DeMore.
Chartina Parks.
Jack Dayer.
Philip Pasquale.
Margaret Dalton.
Robert Pato.
Cornelius Daniels.
Joanne Patrice.
Laurie DeMichael.
Cheryl Patterson.
Mark DeYoung.
Stacy Perlman.
Dominic Del Falso.
Stephanie Penn.
Anthony Del Santo.
Michelle Purz.
Adam Deutsch.
Anthony Peschko.
Christina Dempsey.
Michael Petch.
Denise DeFranco.
Shane Peterson.
Kelly DeGravio.
Nefertiti Peterson.
Regina DeMora.
Carla Petrelia.
Fred DeSanto.
Matthew Phillips.
Thomas DiStefano.
Heather Pickus.
Karen DiTerno.
Melody Pickus.
Meredith Dill.
Vincent Pippa.
Jennifer Dolas.
David Ferrucci.
Michael Donahoe.
Adam Pollock.
Kate Donovan.
Adam Holster.
Adrian Dove.
Michael Popovic.
Eric Dozier.
Thomas Quang.
Ginger Draymond.
Cole Curselli.
Allison Dye.
William Ranke.
Robert Ekman.
Brooke Richardson.
Scott Egan.
Michael Richardson.
Kenneth Eichhorn.
Adam Richmond.
Kevin Eichhorn.
David Richmond.
Bruce Elder.
Helen Rogers.
Ronald Ellis.
LaShone Rogers.
Margaret Elred.
Robert Rohr.
Jason Engelman.
Gregory Rokoff.
Molly Evans.
Lisa Rowland.
Michelle Fegatelli.
Lindsay Rosen.
Stephanie Feldman.
Erica Rossman.
Daniel Fess.
Tina Roth.
Gerard Finan.
Victoria Rosenberg.
Raymond Fiorino Jr.
Christy Rosso.
Stacy Fishman.
Daniel Rubenstein.
Jerome Fistek.
Michael Russo.
Kimberly Fitzpatrick.
Paul Sabatino.
Lisa Flake.
Nicole Seltzer.
Margaret Flowers.
Tracy Sarvey.
Edward Fowler.
Paul Savelli.
Amy Franco.
Please recognize this group of graduates. Timothy Sellover.
Donna Gopershek.
Eric Sanger.
Karen Gale.
Stephanie Senor.
Dora Gazudis.
Leanne Chinhurl.
Maria Galeotto.
Paul Schlechter.
LaShawn Gallagher.
Cheryl Silver.
Matthew Gilbride.
Matthew Simerson.
Paula Gillette.
Frank Simmons.
Richard Gisando.
Jeffrey Simon.
Michael Kliptis.
David Cyaniberger.
Justin Gibb.
Stacy Singer.
Jennifer Goldstein.
Wendy Singer.
Jason Greer.
Christopher Smith.
Ryan Greenberg.
Edward Smith.
Seth Greenby.
Martin Smith.
Therese Griffin.
Elise Snyder.
David Gross.
Karen Sperling.
John Gattuso.
James Spinello.
Gregory Guy.
Nanette Stefanik.
Tamara Guyette.
Jennifer Steiner.
Renee Guzzo.
Catherine Sturbank.
Craig Haas.
James Sticht.
Jeffrey Haas.
Daniel Stavsky.
Christopher Hamm.
Tracy Strong.
Felicia Harris.
Candace Stewart.
Shauna Hatfield.
John Simone.
Lisa Hoffman.
Mila Susmiar.
Laura Health.
Kelly Sweeney.
Matthew Herbo.
Margaret Sweeney.
Daniel Heinigman.
Beth Swolski.
Melanie Harwat.
Gina Tay.
Pamela Hudek.
Alessandra Tamaro.
Richard Hudson.
David Taylor.
Maria Iaboni.
Isonia Thomas.
Karen Ischler.
Sherman Thomas.
Susan Zanin.
Teresa Thomas.
Patrick Jesperger.
Douglas Thorne.
Douglas Jewell.
John Tibaldi.
Heidi Joyner.
Amy Tipton.
James Joynes.
Janine Tober.
Jonathan Kaplan.
Juliet Thomason.
Darlene Cava.
Matthew Tamagian.
Amy Kelly.
Gregory Tracy.
James Kemmerly.
Robert Urban.
Christina Kennaway.
Laura Baccarello.
Jennifer Kidd.
Dominic Velada.
Andrew King.
Wendy Bintz.
Karen Kirshner.
Franca Vitale.
Michael Klein.
Yubica Ujica.
Pamela Klein.
Brett Wagner.
Danielle Lepecki.
Scott Wagner.
Deborah Colpin.
Terry Wallace.
Joseph Kolar.
Mark Waxman.
Amy Witkowski.
Sherelle Webb.
Brandon Whitman.
William Weidenkoff.
Lung Quan Wong.
Jennifer Weiss.
David Wood.
Marianne Welch.
Heather Wood.
Gwendolyn Wheeler.
Jennifer Young.
Verlin Williams. James Wilson. Please let us recognize the class of 1989. Thank you.
marks a major turning point in all of our lives. It is the culmination of many years of hard work and dedication. Reaching this point would not be possible if not for the love, guidance, and support of our parents, families, and teachers. This day of commencement also represents a new beginning. We look to you, Lord, as we move on to future endeavors with hopes of success and happiness. As we look back on our high school years, let it not be with regret, but rather as a time in which we shall cherish. As we go now, we look to the future, and we realize that truly, the best of times are yet to come.
Gonna be